Dear music lovers, today with us, reporting from New York City, the conductor Tara Simoncic. Tara is a young American conductor on the rise, and she frequently works with symphony orchestras as well as opera and ballet company in America and abroad. At the age of six, Tara began studying the trumpet and went on to earn a Bachelor of Music degree in trumpet performance from the New England Conservatory. She performed with the Greenwich Symphony Orchestra, the Flexible Orchestra, and many others. A warm welcome to Tara Simoncic. Hello.
Hello. Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, it's a pleasure. It's a pleasure. Thank you for accepting this interview. I have a lot of questions to ask you. First of all, you are an international renowned conductor, and I know you started your musical journey as a trumpet player. What fascinated you about this instrument?
Well, to be perfectly honest with you, my parents are musicians, and I started playing other instruments before the trumpet, but when I was 6 years old, I decided my mother was a flute player and also a teacher of bands. And I went to a band rehearsal with her and I saw the trumpet and I thought, oh, that's the instrument for me. And the main reason is because all of the cute boys played the trumpet.
It's a very good reason. Yeah, yeah.
Yes, at that time, I guess.
Of course. I know you're doing a lot also for young people to bring them closer to classical music. There are some videos on the web where you and the Woo Orchestra have made special concert lessons with the children, playing music and telling the story of the orchestra. Would you like to talk us about this experience?
Yes, it's a wonderful thing that I'm the conductor. We call them the Young People's Concerts, and I do them with the Greenwich Symphony, which is an orchestra in Connecticut. And every year we do three different concerts that are designed for different age groups. And we have thousands of children that come. We perform three concerts in one day, and we have thousands of children that come to see us perform. And it's very exciting because we get to bring classical music and some new music to them, and they get to also learn about it in their classroom before they come to us. So it's a very cool experience for them.
Wow. What are the reaction when you teach them something, or I mean, when you interact with them?
I feel like the reactions are, they're very interested. They're very excited about it. I try to talk to them like people and not children. And the main thing is, if they can just take one thing away from each concert, then I'm happy. If they can remember the experience for the rest of their lives, then I'm very happy.
Extremely versatile as an orchestra conductor, moving from the symphony to the opera with great ease. But I know that your true passion is ballet. Maybe in another life you would have been a ballerina?
I don't think so, because being a ballerina is extremely difficult. I respect them so much. They have the athleticism and the artistry that they have to do at the same time. and I'm not a very coordinated person if I try to dance, but I really love working with them as a conductor.
What you like about your job and what you don't like?
I think the thing that I like most about my job is this indescribable thing that happens between you and the musicians, or if you're working with dancers, you and the musicians and the dancers, where there's an energy, there's like almost an electricity. You know, I have to show people things through my body, through my face, through my eyes, and if they know what I'm asking for and they respond back to me, and we have this incredible energy, that's the best and most exciting thing about the job. And probably the thing that is the most difficult about the job is, and I do love traveling, I love working with different orchestras and ballet companies, but it can be a little bit of a lonely job, and people don't always know that, and you spend a lot of time in hotel rooms away from home, and that's probably the most difficult thing.
I imagine. But when you're conducting, you prefer to use your hands or the baton?
At this moment, I'm preferring to use my hands because I had an injury from weightlifting a few years ago, and I wasn't able to grab onto things with my hand. It would make the injury much worse. And so I started just not using a baton, and now it feels very free to me.
Good. Our audience is always curious to know more about our guests. Is there a moment in your career that you cherish the most?
I think the moment that I cherish the most is when I first conducted New York City Ballet.
Wow.
And it's just, you. It was during the Nutcracker, and they're already doing the Nutcracker for a few weeks, and I go in as a guest, and you have no rehearsal time with the orchestra, and you just, this is in Lincoln Center, and you just go into the pit, and you have to do it. And I think my mother grew up in New York, and my grandmother always went to Lincoln Center, and she always envisioned me performing there. And I think she would have been very proud, and my family was able to be there, and so it was just a great experience.
You deserve it. You deserve it. You are great. Where we can follow you on social media, and where can we listen to you in future concerts?
You can follow me on Facebook and Instagram, and my website, tarasimoncic.com. And for future concerts, I will be conducting for the first time in Washington, D.C. with the Washington Ballet this May. And also a new exciting thing in May is the New York City Ballet School of Ballet. I will be conducting for them.
Wow, for sure we'll follow you, Tara Simoncic. Thank you so much for this amazing interview. Good luck with your work, and we are waiting for you also here in Milano, maybe in La Scala. Why not?
I hope so. That would be a dream for me, a dream come true. So let's hope so, and grazie and ciao a tutti.
Thank you, Tara. See you soon.
Thank you.